Hello everyone, we will discuss about Qutub Shahi dynasty. Before that, let us see how this dynasty became the masters of the Golconda kingdom. So how this Golconda kingdom came to be? So that was after the disintegration of Bahmani Empire. Bahmani Empire got established in the year 1347 AD. So how this Bahmani Empire came into being? So you all know that Tughlaq dynasty, Tughlaq Empire, it was part of Delhi Sultanate. So Bahmani Sultanate of Deccan was the result of the disintegration and the dismemberment of the Tughlaq Empire. Who was the founder of this Bahmani Empire? Alauddin Hasan. He was one of the nobles in the court of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. So Bahmani Empire acted as a cultural bridge between the north and the south. So let us jump to Muhammad Gawan, as we are discussing about the disintegration of Bahmani Empire. Muhammad Gawan, who was he? He was the prime minister of Muhammad Shah III. So due to the jealousy of nobles, Muhammad Gawan was executed in the year 1482. So naturally, the downfall of the kingdom began and soon got divided into or disintegrated into five new sultanates. What were those? Bidar, Berar, Ahmednagar, Bijapur, and then Golconda. So generally, whenever the central government becomes weak, governors or tarafdars try to assert independence. So naturally, here also it happened. Tarafdars or governors of other principalities asserted independence, but Bidar continued to be under Bahmani monarch. So after the execution of Muhammad Gawan, who became the prime minister? Hasan Nizam ul Mulk. So after him, Qasim Barid was the prime minister. So he was the one to control the person of Bahmani monarch and also the districts adjoining the capital. What is the capital? Bidar. So after Qasim Barid, his son Amir Ali Barid succeeded as the prime minister, and he was able to act as a kingmaker. Who was the last Bahmani ruler? His name was Kalimullah. He fled from the Bidar. He fled from Bidar in the year 1528. So then Amir Ali Barid assumed kingship in the year 1528. So it continued till 1619. That means, so before that, in 1619, what happened? Bijapur under Ibrahim annexed Bidar. Okay, Bidar now became part of Bijapur kingdom. That is Bijapur Sultanate. So, in between these two, one important incident happened. The son of Amir Ali Barid, what was his name? Ali Barid Shah. Amir Ali Barid Shah participated and commanded one wing of the allied armies in the battle of the Krishna. Battle of Krishna had so many names. What was it? Rakshas Thangadi, Tallikota, Battle of Bannihatti. All are same. It was happened in the year 1565 AD. With this, Vijayanagara Empire got disintegrated, and later Aravidu dynasty took over and continued the legacy of Vijayanagara Empire. So Bidar existed between 1528 and 1619. So Ibrahim Adil Shah II invaded Bidar and annexed this kingdom to Bijapur in the year 1619. So even before this, Bijapur Sultan, who is that name? Ismail Adil Shah, captured Bidar. But Sri Krishna Devaraya defeated Ismail Adil Shah and released Bahmani monarch. What was his name? Mahmud. And Sri Krishna Devaraya assumed the title of Yavana Rajya Sthapanacharya. So, and this dynasty had been called Barid Shahis. Barid Shahis. Let us see Berar. Berar came into existence in the year 1490, and it continued to be independent till the year 1574. What is the significance of this? The Bahmani succession state had the shortest span of life. So initially its capital was at Ilichpur and later shifted to Gavilgar. So as we already discussed, the Bahmani kingdom acted as a cultural bridge between the north and the south, and Berar was a buffer state between Malwa, Khandesh and the Deccan. So who was the real founder? Fatullah Imadul Mulk was the founder of this state. So this dynasty had been called Imad Shahis. So Fatullah Imadul Mulk was made governor of Gavilgar by Muhammad Gawan. So we have already discussed that Muhammad Gawan's execution made the central leadership weakened, and then most of the Tarafdars, that means governors, asserted independence, and so Bahmani kingdom disintegrated into five principalities. So, and after Imadul Mulk, Fatullah Imadul Mulk, Alauddin succeeded and he assumed the title Imad Shah. So if we jump to the annexation of Berar to Ahmednagar, we have to see who was ruling Ahmednagar in the year 1574. Murtaza Nizam Shah. So Murtaza Nizam Shah was related by marriage to the Imad Shahi dynasty. So Murtaza Nizam Shah, after a short siege, annexed Berar in the year 1574. So let's see Ahmednagar. So Ahmednagar came into existence in the year 1490, and it continued to be exist as an independent state till 1633. In the year 1633, Ahmednagar annexed to the Mughal Empire during Shah Jahan. So the founder of the Nizam Shahi dynasty was Ahmed. So who was the son of Hasan Nizam ul Mulk? So what was his role? So he was the prime minister of Bahmani Empire after Muhammad Gawan's execution. So, and Ahmed was appointed as the governor of Daulatabad. In the year 1494, Ahmed founded the city of Ahmednagar, and then he shifted his capital from Junnar to Ahmednagar. So this is a short brief history of Ahmednagar principality, and let's see Bijapur. So it came into being in the year 1490 and it continued to be independent till 1686. Yusuf Adil Shah was the founder of Adil Shahi dynasty and he was a protege of Muhammad Gawan. That means most of the governors and important leaders were the proteges of Muhammad Gawan, and after his execution, most of them asserted independence. So now let's see Tilang. It was a Bahmani province. It came into existence in the year 1512. It continued to be an independent principality till 1687. Earlier, we have discussed that Bijapur continued to exist till 1686. And now Tilang, that is Golconda, existed till 1687. Both these principalities were annexed to the Mughal Empire during Aurangzeb. So this Tilang was ruled by Qutub Shahis. Qutub Shahis belonged to a Turkish tribe called Karakanelu, and they were originally from Persia and Transoxiana. And we now treat it as a Central Asia. Quli Hamdani had got a job in the court of Muhammad Shah III. So he was the Bahmani Sultan of Bidar. So he was the one who executed Muhammad Gawan. Okay. So what was the capital of Bahmani Empire? Initially, Gulbarga was the capital. Later, Ahmad Shah Wali transferred the capital from Gulbarga to Bidar. So during his Ahmad Shah Wali reign, capital was transferred from Gulbarga to Bidar. So Bahmani Sultan Ahmad Shah bestowed on Quli Hamdani the title. What was that? Qawas Khan. And granted him the Jagir of Kurangal. Why was it like that? Due to his skill in hunting. Okay. Next, later he was made the Tarafdar, or that means the governor of Tilang with Golconda as capital. Golconda as a capital. The Bahmani ruler granted him the title Qutub ul Mulk. And actually, what happened? So, though other principalities asserted independence in 1490, Quli Qutb continued his allegiance towards Bahmani monarch. What happened? So, in the year 1512, he declared independence because of one person, that is the Prime Minister of Bahmani Empire. Who is that? Amir Ali Barid. He was also called as a cunning fox of Deccan. Cunning fox of the Deccan. So, Quli Qutb Shah fortified Golconda fort and named it as a Muhammad Nagar. This was named after his overlord. Who was that? Muhammad Shah III. So, Quli Qutb Shah was the contemporary of Sri Krishna Devaraya and who ruled from 1509 to 29, and Achyut Raya, who ruled it from 29 to 42. 1529 to 42. So, this was the south. And what about the north? In the north, his contemporaries were Babur from 1526 to 30, and then his son Humayun. And Quli Qutb Shah soon consolidated his position and started expansion. He took steps to maintain good relations with Sri Krishna Devaraya, and he took the risk of capturing the forts of Rachakonda and even Devarakonda, which was formed part of a Vijayanagara, by defeating Velama chiefs. And because it was all happened because of one particular reason, that is, Achyut Raya's position was undermined due to the intrigues of Ramaraya. Okay, and who was the ambitious son-in-law of Sri Krishna Devaraya? Quli Qutb Shah even occupied Panagal and consolidated his position. There was an attack on Govilconda by Quli Qutb Shah, and it was a success. So what was the result? Golconda kingdom became immediate neighborhood of both Vijayanagara as well as Bijapur. So this Govilconda was an important location, that is, strategically it was an important location. So Quli kept his relation as Kiladar. So who was he? Jaffa Beg. As it became an immediate neighborhood, Bijapur Sultan Ismail Adil Shah attacked Govilconda. So the Battle of Govilconda ended in 1534 when Ismail Adil Shah died suddenly due to fatigue. Here, Golconda army was led by Fateh Khan and Hyder Khan. So Qutb Shah came into conflict with even Shitab Khan, and who was called by the name Sitapati, was the ruler of Warangal. So Quli Qutb Shah occupied Warangal region and Khammam by defeating Shitab Khan. So meanwhile, Achyut Raya occupied Kondavidu, but Qutb Shah failed to occupy this one. Quli Qutb Shah had defeated the feudatories of the Gajapatis, Gajapatis of Orissa. So, and Qutub Shah annexed Rajahmundry, Eluru, and other regions in that location. Later, he came to an understanding with the Gajapatis by fixing the river Godavari as the boundary. Godavari as the boundary. So, Ali Barid Shah of Bidar, this was another important incident happened during Quli Qutub Shah. Ali Barid Shah of Bidar, with the help of Bijapur ruler, that is Ibrahim, occupied Medak as well as Kaulas. But Ali Barid returned these areas to the Qutub Shah due to the intervention of Shia leaders. Normally, Quli faced many revolts. For example, you can say Harishchandra of Nalgonda. And he revolted against Quli. So, Quli Qutub Shah followed a policy of toleration. And the best example for it is Ram Raju occupied prominent position in administration. Rama Raju. Sultan Quli was assassinated by his son Jamshid in the year 1543. That means Quli Qutub Shah rule was extended between 1512 and 1543. So, at that time, his age was 98 years. So, naturally, Jamshid was tired of waiting for the throne. So, he assassinated his father and ruled for next 7 years. And what was the contribution of Quli Qutub Shah? And Tilang and the region located in between Krishna and Godavari rivers came directly under his control. That means political unification of Andhras took place under him.